I'm going to continue on the topic of how we're making observability easier for a wider audience to adopt. And to do that, I'm going to talk about Explore Metrics and Explore Logs. Some of you may remember we first announced these back in April at GrafanaCon. What they are experiences that allow you to navigate data stored in Prometheus or any Prometheus-compatible backend, like Mir, or in the case of Explore Logs, a Loki backend, and do it without having to write a query language, say PromQL or LogQL. And why is this? We'd heard from a lot of users that one of the biggest challenges to getting started with observability is the fact that you had to learn a query language before you could actually start to get any value out of your observability data. So what we did with Explore Metrics and Explore Logs is that we now have replaced typing queries with a point-and-click UI. We've replaced empty start screens with pre-populated visualizations, making it possible for anyone from day one to start getting value out of their metrics and logs. Now, since we announced this back in April, we've seen a ton of enthusiasm and adoption for both of these. And given that, we've spent the last couple months really listening to early adopter feedback and making a lot of improvements to both. And that's why today I'm super excited to announce the fact that both Explore Metrics and Explore Logs are now generally available for both cloud and in open source. Now, we made a number of improvements in the lead up to GA. With Explore Metrics, we've improved our related metrics section, making it easier and better recommendations about what metrics you should look at based on the one you currently have open. With Explore Logs, we added the ability to automatically visualize attributes stored in Loki's structured metadata. This is particularly great for those of you out there using OpenTelemetry logging. We also tuned our pattern detection functionality so that we can quickly surface the most common patterns in your log lines to you. And we're definitely not done there. After this GA, we intend to fast follow with a number of upgrades to both Explore Metrics and Logs. For Explore Metrics, we're adding support for native histograms, a higher resolution histogram type relative to classic histograms. We're also going to be incorporating machine learning into our related metrics, so we can surface metrics that have similar shapes and patterns to all of your users. With Explore Logs, we're adding streaming support, both to your graphs and to the log lines we show you, which means less time for you waiting around for results. Now, based on the success of both Explore Metrics and Explore Logs, I'm excited to announce that we have two new additions to the family, Explore Traces and Profiles. We've decided to extend the experience of these two across all the pillars of observability. Both of Explore Traces and Profiles are available in public preview, again, both in cloud and in open source. Upon completing this suite of Explore apps, what we can now offer is a full suite of options. So each user can choose how it is that they want to work. This reflects our belief that observability isn't a one-size-fits-all solution. For those who are going to want that full control and infinite flexibility, they can type out queries in code mode. And let me tell you, I have been blown away by the things I've seen some of the folks on our engineering team do with these like 50 plus line PromQL queries. For those who want something kind of more in the middle, there's the builder mode. That's sort of what I think of as maybe like a low code or a visual programming experience. That's going to be a great way actually to learn the query languages because it gives you a point and click way to string together numerous operations. And then for those that just want push to start, let's get going, we have the Explore apps. No queries, no code, just easy insights. Whew. Well, it wouldn't be a Grafana Labs keynote without a live demo, so I'm going to try to do this right now. You know, I had wanted to do a video demo, and then Tom told me that was lame. So please cross your fingers for me. I'm about to take you on a little ride through Explore Traces, one of our newest additions to the family. Now, I'm a product manager, which means I've left the noble discipline of engineering, but let's pretend, for the sake of this demo, that Jen is still an engineer working on an e-commerce platform. If you drop into Explore Traces, let's say I'm just here on the screen, and let's say I've gotten a page that my error budget SLO for my product catalog service is burning down a bit quicker than we would expect. Dropping into the main Explore pages, Explore Traces page, you see your red metrics at the top, your request rate, error rate, and your duration. Since my page was about errors, I'm going to start by selecting errors. Helpfully down here, you'll see that Explore Traces automatically breaks down that error rate by service name. Since my page was about the product catalog service, I'll quickly add that to my filters. The next thing you kind of ask yourself in a classic debugging workflow is, what is unique about these requests that are erroring as compared to the ones that are completing successfully? Luckily, now we have this comparison tab to help you with that. What the comparison is going to do is compare a selection, in this case, the selected traces are my erroring traces, to my baseline. So those are the traces representing requests that are completing successfully. What Explore Traces is going to do is, out of the box, it's going to look at every single attribute on my traces and compare the baseline to the selection. It's going to sort to the top the attributes that show the largest delta between the baseline and the selection. And what do I see? Quickly push to the top here. Well, it actually looks like all of my errors are happening on one particular product ID. And clicking inspect, that's exactly what I can see. This product ID represents all of the errors. All of the other product IDs seem to be completing just fine. I can quickly add that product ID to my filters. And then from there, I can actually open up some erroring traces matching that criteria. Again, speeding along my debugging because I go to exactly the sort of representative trace that I want. Now, let's pretend while we've been here dealing with our error SLO, I at the same time got a notification from my support team. It seems like some of my users on my e-commerce site are complaining that the site's loading pretty slowly for them. Maybe they weren't using the synthetics that Tom was talking about. So there, since the page is about slow loading, what I'm going to do is look at my duration signal. Again, the first thing you see is that Explore Traces is showing you all of your services and breaking down their P90 latencies. What I can see is that I have several services with P90s on the order of seconds. So I want to now figure out what, again, is going wrong. And so again, I ask myself, what is unique about these high latency requests versus those that are completing in a reasonable amount of time? Again, I come over to my trusty comparison tab. This time, we can actually use a selection ability in the Explore Traces app to pick a set of traces. I'm going to try to select here the slowest of the slow traces here up top. Then I'm going to be able to compare the traces falling in this selection, this orange box, to the traces falling outside of that, my baseline. I'm going to hope that my page actually loads. All right, there we go. And so again, you see the distinction. We're automatically comparing across all attributes, the difference between my selection, my super slow traces, and my baseline. Since support said it was something related to some users, I'll quickly filter down to user-related attributes. And what I can see is, hey, there's a certain set of user IDs that seem to be in the slow traces group, and then a certain set that are in my baseline. I can similarly see, if I look at the user.location, that certain locations are disproportionately represented in those slow traces. So that allows me to, again, narrow my search and look at traces from those particular locations to figure out what's going on. It's also great for me because I can go back to support and say, hey, this looks like this probably isn't an issue for all of our users, but it's just a subset.